السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Allah Almighty says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ, describing the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, you are indeed upon an outstanding level of character and conduct. My brothers, my sisters, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, had he not been outstanding in every aspect of his life, it was impossible to have billions of people follow him and emulate every aspect of that life. As simple as that. So to begin with, we need to ask ourselves, how is it that there are billions and over the centuries, trillions of people who have followed and continue to follow this man, the greatest of those to tread this earth according to us as Muslims? And subhanAllah, on the other hand, you have people who say things that are unfortunately inaccurate due to their ignorance. You and I know it's not possible to listen to someone who's arrogant, who doesn't care, who's not bothered. But when someone cares, they respect you, they treat you with utmost respect and dignity, kindness, then indeed you will lend them an ear. And when they speak to you, you will listen to what they have to say. If what they have to say makes a lot of sense and you see that they're living their lives in accordance with what they're saying, you will be attracted not only to the person, but to the message as well. The same applies to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. If you know him, you will definitely love him. And what this means is, if you do not love him, it is because you don't really know him. So we have dedicated this beautiful week to highlighting some aspects of this great man who was the greatest of creation, the greatest to tread this earth according to the Muslims, according to all of us. And we ask Allah to make it an opportunity that will help us reaffirm the goodness that we have, and at the same time an opportunity to educate those who are unaware of this great man and what he stood for. From a very early age, he was known as As-Sadiq Al-Amin. He was known as the truthful, the trustworthy. So his friends knew that this person doesn't lie, he doesn't cheat or deceive. And this was prior to prophethood. So imagine, before prophethood already, Allah had prepared the stage for this beautiful message that was about to be delivered. The man chosen was one whom all his friends, community, knew him as a trustworthy person, a very pleasant person, an honest person. When he was young, he went on some trade missions for a lady later to be his wife, known as Khadija bint Khuwaylid, later to be known as radiyallahu anha, may Allah be pleased with her. When he came back from the first mission and he presented what happened and he gave the accounts of all the transactions and all the business that took place, immediately she knew, this man is not just honest or trustworthy, but he is outstanding. Hence here is Allah telling us, لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You are upon an outstanding level of character and conduct. And this would mean any one of us, if you'd like to achieve success, if you'd like to achieve greatness, you have to take a page from the character and conduct of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And when I say a page, it's because we are not perfect. But our strive towards perfection should be a dedication that is lifetime. May the Almighty help us improve on a daily basis so that we can become people who are known at least as honest and trustworthy. Imagine no deception from the very beginning. And this is why at the age of 40, when he declared the message that Allah Almighty placed on his shoulders to declare to the people, who were those who accepted the message primarily? His friends and the closest circle. Because they knew him best. If you know him, you will love him. Well, they knew him from prior to prophethood, so they loved him the most. Subhanallah. Common sense. If your own friends and those who are the closest to you do not accept you, then you need to know you cannot be a good person. And this is why the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, later says, خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ, the best from amongst you is he who is best to his wife, or she who is best to her spouse, or those who are the best to their family members to begin with. Which means, if your wife can bear witness that you are a good person, then you are indeed a good person. If your husband can bear witness that you are a good person, then you are indeed a good person. If your family members can bear witness that you are good, then you are indeed good, because they see you 24/7. They interact with you at times of hardship, at times of ease, when you are slightly upset and when you are happy. They see all the sides of you and they know you, as we say, inside out. The same would apply. The closest circle of friends, if you were to get up and say, guys, I have a business deal and we're going to make 1,000,000 dirhams in a few days. If they laugh at you, it goes to show what they think of you, right? If they scoff at you, it goes to show that they don't even trust you. But if they take you seriously and they put their money straight there and say, let's go for it, what does it mean? They trust that you will be able to achieve what you are saying. So when people talk and say negative things about the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, it is because they do not know him. Those who knew him from the very beginning, they accepted his message. Take a look at his closest friend, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. When the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, returned from Mi'raj, the ascension, when the people tried to ask a question, the people of Quraysh were asking a question to his friends and those who were his followers, and they said, would you believe that a man could have made this journey in one night and come back? What was the answer? What was the answer of Abu Bakr? And that's when he became known as As-Siddiq. Immediately he said, if he said this, it's the truth. Why? Because this man did not lie to us about matters of this world. Not a penny did he lie in order to achieve. Not a position did he have to lie in order to achieve. He did not deceive us in matters of this worldly life. Why would he deceive us in matters of the hereafter? He wouldn't. So we know him. If he said it, it's the truth. And then look at his statements. Subhanallah, what did he say? He asked us to be kind to one another. La yarhamillahu man la yarhamin nas. A statement of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Allah Almighty will not have mercy upon the one who does not have mercy on the rest of the people. Khayrun nasi anfa'uhum linnasi. Here are the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. If you know him, you will love him. What did he say? The best of the people are the ones who have benefited the rest of the people the most. Subhanallah. خَيْرٌ النَّاسِ أَنْفَعُهُمْ لِلنَّاسِ. Who can say these words? Would a man who is planning to harm you ever instruct all his followers to be the best to others? When the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, spoke about those who work for others and those who work for you and I, he says they are your brothers and sisters. Do not burden them with that which will be difficult for them to fulfill. And if you are to give them a task that is difficult, you help them fulfill the task as well. Look at the teachings. When he says, "Ana wa kafilu liyatimi kahataini fil jannah," he says, "Myself and the one who takes care of an orphan shall be like these two fingers in paradise." And he has put the fingers together. Why would he say that? He was a great man. He taught only goodness. He brought only mercy from the Almighty, and he taught it to us. And this is why the Almighty says that he has sent the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, as a source of mercy, not just for humankind, but for entire creation, for everyone and everything. Allah Almighty says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have not sent you except as a source of mercy for Al-Alameen. Al-Alameen includes absolutely everything, not just humankind, but the animals, the birds, the environment, the species. Today we talk about preserving the ecosystem, the oceans, the water. We talk about global warming. We talk about everything else. All this is included in the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, when he speaks about preservation, when he speaks about consideration. He speaks about how you should manage yourself even when you are on a stream of water. What you should do and shouldn't do, contaminating the water and how bad that is, providing clean water for people, giving life in the sense that you have reached out to those who are struggling. He says the Almighty will reach out to you in your struggles. Whoever has gone out of his way to assist another in his or her time of crisis, Allah Almighty will alleviate his own struggles in this world and the next. That means he wants you to help one another. He wants you to respect one another. We have an incident where the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, issued an instruction to his companions at a time when it was the Asr prayer. And the companions interpreted it in two different ways. And at the end of the day, one of them said, "Well, let's pray now." And the other said, "No, we follow the instruction of the Prophet and we will pray a little bit later." They did not fight each other over that. Rather, they said, "Let's do as we've understood and we will get to him and ask him." When they got to him and asked him, he knew that each one of them was actually following what he said as per what they understood of it. And so he said, "You are both correct." Subhanallah, amazing. You are both correct. Those who fulfilled their prayer at the time and those who delayed it slightly and fulfilled the instruction as it was from the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Both of them were corrected by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This goes to show the greatness of this man, how he always tried to listen, how he tried to resolve matters. There was a woman who came to him complaining about her husband. He listened to what she had to say, and Allah revealed verses instructing him what to do. He called this woman with utmost respect and gave her her due. This was the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. His sense of justice was amazing. And it is the Quran that speaks about being just. even if it is against yourselves, even if it is against your own family members. But that is the Quran. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, speaks about a charity and how important it is, and not just that which is monetary, but he says the expression on your face is also a charity. Which expression? The positive expressions, the smile. When you smile, subhanallah, what do you achieve? He says, smile, the smiling upon the face of your brother is an act of charity. Wow. So he wants you to have a good expression. Did you know that nowadays, the studies have proven that when you have a good expression on your face, you actually empower those you interact with and you cheer them up and create a positivity within them simply by virtue of your positive expression. If we were all gloomy, even those who are happy would look at us and become sad. But if you have a smile on your face, those who are having a bad day would smile back at you. Try it. The greatness of this man, if you know him, you will love him. I imagine this man always smiling, subhanallah. Always trying to empower people with this positivity, and it's there. And he tells us, Bashira wala tunaffira wa yassira wala tu'assira. Imagine the words. He's sending his companions to spread a good message of Islam to Yemen. And he tells them, give good news, don't give bad news, which means encourage people, do not discourage them. Speak positively, not negatively. And make things easy, don't make them difficult. He's telling his companions, make things easy, don't make things difficult for others. In fact, مَا خُيِّرَ بَيْنَ أَمْرَيْنِ إِلَّا اخْتَارَ أَيْسَرَهُمَا. Another teaching. Whenever the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was faced with more than one way of doing something, he always chose the easier way for as long as it was not a sin. He always chose the easier way and he made it easy for us. And if you create ease for someone, Allah will create ease for you. Let's take a look at business dealings. What did he say? Here is the man. We celebrate his existence and we claim and we are his followers. And we are here to talk about him because the more you know, the more you will love him. And together with that, you should be following him because when you love someone, you follow them. Have you seen the footballers? Have you seen the pop stars? Have you seen the others who are loved by people? You will automatically know this guy is a Messi fan. Why? Because his hair is cut the same way. Agreed? You know this guy is a follower of such and such, a pop star. Why? Because his clothing has an emblem that proves he is with them. For example, or your team. You support a team, you love them to pieces. What do? You show that this is who I am. So if you love the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, the minute someone sees you, they should know you're a Muslim. That's it. Something should give it away straight away. It's okay, mashallah. Your name, your dress code, your character, your smile, your conduct. I remember once walking into an office and I was smiling and everyone was just looking down. They look at me. And then they give you a double look because they expect a bearded man not to be smiling. They expect a bearded man to be harsh and to walk down looking at everyone as though, oh, it's about to end. Everything's about to come to an end here. No. So one lady asks me, what is the secret behind your positivity? You walked into this place and there was so much of positive energy beaming. I said, I just try to follow the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And I'm nowhere near, but I try. And I keep trying. And one of the things is, to be happy upon whatever the Almighty has chosen for you. So I do have a very difficult day, but I'm happy. It could have been worse. That's a teaching of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Do you know what he says? When something happens that is negative, look at those who are in a worse off position than you in order for you to appreciate, you know what? It could have been bad. It could have been worse. I'm actually blessed that it's not as bad as what other people have. You lost your job, you still have savings. Others have lost their jobs and they don't have savings. Aren't you blessed? You lost your job, you don't have savings, you still have your body and your health. Others do not have the bodies and healths. You still have your family, others don't. You lost one member of the family, others have lost all. So he tells you, look at those who have been affected and inflicted in a bigger way, and it will help you appreciate what you have. Regarding business, like I said earlier, this is what he had to say. He says, when you are buying, be considerate of the seller. And when you are selling, be considerate of the buyer. Whoa. Subhanallah. When I want to buy something, I walk into the store here and I ask the brother or the sister or whoever it may be, what's the price? And they tell me 100 dirhams. And I tell them, I pay you 30 dirhams. Is that fair? You're allowed to bargain, but be considerate of this person. They are trying to make a living. If you said, no, let's give you 80, or no, do something better than 100. It's okay. It's fine. They might say, okay, the best price is 80, or I can give it to you at 90. But be considerate. Has Allah not blessed you? Are you not going to help another person earn a living? Are you not going to help them put a plate of food for their families at the end of the day on the table? Do you not think that if you were to give them 5 more, perhaps it might help them a little bit more? Subhanallah. Here is the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. If you know him, you will love him. He says, be considerate about the buyer when you are selling. Don't rip them off. You see a rich man coming and you know what you are selling is 100 dirhams. But because you saw the G-Wagon come straight through, you told him 200 dirhams. Why? Subhanallah. Be considerate this way and be considerate the other way as well. I need to walk out from the deal in a way that I'm happy and the one I bought from is also happy. That is called a follower of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. These are his teachings. He says, honor your women, respect them, do not abuse them, be careful how you talk to them. Why did he give so much of importance to that? Because he knows. At that particular time, they were going through a period of ignorance where they maltreated women to a degree that was unheard of. He came in and he had, I wouldn't like to call it the guts and the courage because he was a prophet of Allah. But he stood firm. He even showed his companions how to be romantic towards their spouses when that was something unheard of at the time. It was something unheard of at the time. There was a time when his wife, Aisha radiallahu anha, wanted to move from one camel to another because of how slow the camel was. Immediately, he was happy to do that. Imagine if you were driving out and your wife says, no, I want to go in the Mercedes, or I want to go in the other car. What would you say? Subhanallah. Huh? Do you think it's your car? You can keep on going with your Toyota. By the way, I'm a Toyota man. But I'm only giving you an example. This is the man. If you know him, you will love him. But when you don't know him, you won't be able to fulfill the due that he is owed. May peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was the one who came up with a beautiful solution When his tribe were having an argument about who should pick up the black stone and place it on the Kaaba, they called him in because they knew he was fair. This was prior to prophethood. And he solved the problem because there were so many tribes, each one wanted the honor of taking this black stone and placing it on the Kaaba. And he decided, no, let's get a cloth and each one of your leaders will hold a part of it and I will place it and I'll place it on. So everyone participated. He is the one who told us, if you interact with people and bear patience upon what they might say, it's better for you than to go all alone away from everyone. Wow. So if you interact with your family, there will be negatives. There will be a little bit of politics. It happens with every family. But he says, the better of the people are those who interact and bear patience. Yes, to a certain degree. When it starts affecting your sanity and when it starts affecting your health, you might want to take a step back. That is fine too. But don't let that be your first decision. The minute you have a little issue, I'm never going back. No, that's your family chosen by Allah. Those are your relatives. Those are your people. Those are those who you work with. Make peace. He is the one who says, لَيْسَ الْوَاصِلُ بِالْمُكَافِ إِنَّمَا الْوَاصِلُ الَّذِي مَنْ إِذَا قُطِعَ رَحِمُهُ وَصَلَهَا. On one hand, he's asked us to fulfill family ties. Then he explains, the person who's fulfilling the family ties is not the one who has a tit-for-tat relationship. They gave, I gave. They came, we went. They did, we did. The true person fulfilling family ties is the one whom, when the other party has broken the relation, they make an effort and a constant effort to build it. They make a constant effort to mend it. And this is why Allah Almighty revealed verses. لا خير في كثير من نجواهم إلا من أمر بصدقة أو معروف أو إصلاح بين الناس. When people have their little meetings, Allah Almighty is describing, the good is only in that which is encouraging people to do good or to give a charity or to resolve matters between people, to mend relations. Are you going to be a true follower of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him? Today I'm addressing Muslims and non-Muslims. Those who are Muslims, we already say we know him. But in actual fact, you will get to know more and more, and you will follow more and more by the will of Allah, and you will get to love more and more, and you will, subhanallah, achieve peace and comfort in your life. And in the hereafter, you will see great success. And then we are addressing non-Muslims who might not have heard about the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, except from those who don't really know him. So they only utter negatives. And like I said right at the beginning, it's impossible to have a man who is totally negative have billions and trillions of people across the globe living by his teachings, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, those who have hated on him, what has happened to them? People have gone out of their way to do things that are hurtful to those who love him. People have gone out of their way to say things that are unfair, unjust, that are wrong. They intentionally create misconceptions in order to confuse people. So the Almighty tells us, guidance is in my hands. I am the turner of the hearts. What has he done? A lot of those who have been involved in this type of hate have gotten to a point beyond which
They cannot hate anymore. And after that, what happens? I remember a brother, I met a brother. He told me that I was involved in creating a video that was very derogatory about the Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him. I was involved in this and I actively participated in spreading ignorance about this man because I myself was ignorant about him. And he says, there was a point after which I thought to myself, I've done everything I can in order to show my hate towards this man. Let me pick up and read about him to find out what more I could do. And he says, when I picked up and started reading from the sources, and I started realizing that, you know what? I've actually picked on the wrong man. I began to love what I was reading. I began to love what I was hearing. And I started looking at the mainstream Muslims across the globe. And I started witnessing the honesty. I started witnessing the dedication. I started seeing the modesty. I started seeing the uprightness. I saw the calmness. I started feeling the peace. I looked at the mosques, and just by looking at them, he says, I could feel the tranquility. I could feel the connection. And he says, there came a time when I started seeing beautiful visions. And as I read more, I began to look into the belief. And I realized that this man never called towards worshiping himself, but rather he called towards worshiping the one who made you and I and entire creation. And I said, you know what? That is a fair message. And one day I went to the masjid and declared my faith, and I said, I bear witness there is none worthy of worship besides he who made me, and I have to bear witness that Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the messenger of Allah. How did it start? It started off with hate. Where did it end? It ended off with love.
عَسَى اللَّهُ أَن يَجْعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ الَّذِينَ عَادَيْتُمْ مِنْهُمْ مَوَدًّا وَاللَّهُ قَدِيرٌ.
Amazing. Allah says, Allah is all able, all capable of creating love between you and the one whom you hate or dislike, because Allah is all capable. So people of our times are telling us, we started off with hate, and when we got to know the teachings, the real teachings, and when we got to understand what was being taught and to clear some of our misconceptions, we fell in love. And when we fell in love, we knew that, yes, I want to enter this faith, that I've become a follower of this man. I become a follower. And subhanallah, that's the love. That's the greatness of character. When people inflicted harm upon him, what did he do? One of the first things he did was to pray to Allah to soften their hearts. You and I might have heard about the incident of Ta'if. Ta'if, the place not far off from Mecca, where the people had come out to pelt him, to tell him to leave, physically causing harm. He had an opportunity to pray against them for their destruction. But he says, no, I've been sent as a point of mercy. Oh Allah, guide my people, they don't know. Oh Allah, guide my people, they don't know what they're doing. What happened? A matter of time, the hearts were softened and the people came one after the other until the whole of Ta'if accepted Islam and followed him and continue to this day to follow his message. Yes, there are rules and regulations. Yes, he came and told us these rules and regulations, something known as halal, something known as haram. Halal meaning permissible, permissible to consume, to eat, permissible to do the dealings and whatever else it may be. And haram means that which is prohibited. All of that, if you look into it, it's for your betterment and mine. It is for your good health and mine. Look at the teachings, what to eat, what not to eat. If you study it carefully, you will begin to love this man who brought these teachings to you and I free of charge. And he's teaching you how to eat healthy, how to live healthy, how to sleep on time, how you will be rewarded if you sleep in the early hours of the night and you get up early and you have a good day, how to be as productive as possible, how not to be lazy, how not to be angry. A young man comes to him and says, give me advice. For whatever reason, I'd like to think this man must have been, you know, energetic and fiery. The Prophet says, La taghdab. He says, give me more advice. La taghdab. What's the meaning of La taghdab? It means, don't get angry. Don't get angry. Calm down. Don't get angry. And he kept repeating it. What a great man. What a great man. Let me give you an example of his greatness. Here comes a Bedouin Arab who was perhaps unaware. He walks into the Prophet's masjid, the one in Medina. And he had the urge to urinate. And so he decides, let me go to one corner and urinate. But he was in the masjid. Obviously, it was not as it is today with the marble and the carpets. No, it was different. But it was still the house of Allah. So this man urinated in the corner. It requires great leadership to deal with this crisis. It requires great leadership to solve the matter forever. A man urinating. The companions got up and almost wanted to beat him. He says, La tazmuru. Do you know what that means? Leave him, let him finish his thing. Do not stop him in that way. Do not admonish him. I always sit and think and I giggle to myself when I think about how difficult it is when halfway through your urination, someone says, stop. What do you do now? What do you do? Crazy, right? So here is the man sent as a source of mercy saying, let him finish, it's too late now. When he finished, he sends his companions because he did not want this to belittle this man. He sends his companions to get some water, to pour water over it. In the meantime, he speaks to this man and says, you know what? This is a masjid. This is a house of Allah. It is to pray. It is to read Quran. It is for the remembrance of Allah. It is not for urination. And it is not for this type of thing. Now the man is comparing, and this is very interesting. He's comparing what the companions were going to do to him and what the leader himself is saying to him. Now, one might ask, why were the companions going to do that anyway? Well, this had not happened before, so they did not know how to deal with it. I mean, you and I, today, if you go to any mosque and you see someone urinating on the side, and it's not going to happen, trust me. But if you do see someone, what would you do? It's unthinkable. Am I right? It's unthinkable. So this man says, Allahumma arhamni warham Muhammadan wa la tarham ma'ana ahadan. He was so relieved. He says, oh Allah, have mercy on me, have mercy on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't have mercy on anyone else. Now you've got a new problem. What's the new problem? The new problem is now we need to teach him that the mercy of Allah is not just for you and I, it's for everyone. Right? Allah says his mercy encompasses everything. وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ Allah says, my mercy encompasses absolutely everything. Wow. So now the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, obviously listening to this man, tells him, you are trying to make narrow what is very, very broad, which means the mercy of Allah is far wider, broader, more encompassing than what you've just uttered now. Did this solve the problem? Yes, it did. If you know him, you will love him. I think about this particular particular incident, and there are thousands of other incidents. And I tell myself, imagine if he was in our midst. If I made a mistake, or you made a mistake, or we made a blunder, if he tackled a person who urinated in the masjid with such love, how do you think he would tackle you and I? With greater love. So when speaking to people, speak with love, speak with kindness, speak in a soft tone when you are addressing people in order to remind them. Yes, you may be firm, but in a polite way, mashallah. When he addressed gatherings and when he spoke to his companions, he raised his voice. Where needed, he did what was needed. But when he addressed the children and the others, and this man, for example, and others who needed guidance, he did so in a beautiful way. This is Muhammad, peace be upon him. When he entered Medina Munawwara, he guaranteed the safety of all those who were there, be they Muslim or not. He guaranteed their safety. He struck a covenant with them. He told them, we will ensure that you guys are all safe. That's what it was. Why? Because it was their city. In order to see the progress of the city, you need peace and understanding amongst its people. If there is no peace and understanding amongst the people of a place, how will it grow? Even your own business. If there is no understanding amongst those who are at work, what do you expect? And by the way, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, asks us to pay the wage of the one who is working before his sweat or perspiration dries. Some of the scholars have spoken about the narration, but the meaning of it is absolutely valid, and it is an Islamic teaching. When you pay the correct wage. And when do you pay it? At the correct time. Because if you don't, it's going to cause a lot of issues for so many people. It has a skittle effect. So this is Muhammad, peace be upon him, telling us even about those who work for us. Pay them on time, pay them correctly, treat them with respect, and remember, don't abuse them. He says a believer is not abusive. A believer is not deceiving. A believer does not harm his neighbors. If you believe in the Almighty and the last day, the day of accounting, meaning the day of judgment, you will not harm your neighbors. How many of us claim to be his followers, but we harm our neighbors? So an occasion like this is an occasion to go back and reflect and renew the love and the following. Whoever believes in the Almighty and the last day, this is what the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is saying, then you should honor your guest. Someone comes knocking at your door, honor them. What is the honor? The minimum is to treat them with respect, and then perhaps to honor them in whatever way befitting. He says, if you are cooking your food, add a little bit of water, add something a little bit more, and perhaps give the neighbors. Subhanallah, he did not speak about how rich or poor they may be, but the idea is to reach out to your neighbors, to show them you are our neighbors, you have rights over us, we have rights over you. We are together, we are going to make this neighborhood a beautiful place. You know, when you live in an area, when you live in a neighborhood and the people are greeting each other, they don't harm each other, they look out for you and your property when you are perhaps not there. And they ask about you. If they don't see you in the masjid or somewhere that you are acquainted and accustomed, maybe dropping the children off at the school or whatever else it may be, they ask about you. That sense of belonging is unmatched. It is amazing. It is beautiful. Islam is based on the sense of belonging. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, we are all like one body. If a single organ is in pain, the entire body is restless. That's how it should be. What a great man. If you know him, you will love him. I could go on and on, speaking about so many aspects of his life. I haven't even started. We could talk about the miracles that have happened in his life. From prior to his birth, to the birth, to his infancy, childhood, teenage years, beyond. And we could talk about the aspects one after the other. I haven't even spoken about what he looked like. Maybe I should say a thing or two before I close. He was so pleasant that when he looked at anyone, the companions say, they felt they were the most loved by him than anyone else. Each one of them felt the same. لَا يَحْسَبُ جَلِيسُهُ أَنَّ أَحَدًا أَكْرَمَ إِلَيْهِ مِنْهُ. None of those who were around him felt that there was anyone else who was more loved by him than them. And all of them felt the same at the same time. Wow, that's a miracle. Imagine to make people feel loved. I care for you. I would never harm you. I really would like to see you grow. I would love to see goodness for you. That was the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. He gave them beautiful advice. He always gave them the face, which means a pleasant face. We are weak. We are far off. Generations down. We are trying. We will never get to perfection, but the struggle is real. We need to improve ourselves. We need to constantly look at the example of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. I promise you, we need to learn. The more we know, the more we will love him, and it will encourage us to follow. It will encourage us to become beautiful people, holistic. We are good in everything we do. Imagine every aspect of living, he has a teaching in that regard. His companions say, مَا تَرَكَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ خَيْرًا إِلَّا وَدَلَّنَا عَلَيْهِ وَلَا شَرًّا إِلَّا حَذَّرَنَا مِنْهُ. There was no good that he forgot to teach us. And there was no bad that he forgot to warn us from. That was the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. وَجْهُهُ كَأَنَّهُ قِطْعَةُ قَمَرٍ. His face was shining as though it was a piece of the moon. So bright, so beautiful, so loving, so caring. That was the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. When the children saw him, they loved him. When the older people saw him, they loved him. Abdullah ibn Salam was a Jewish rabbi. He heard and read and learned about the signs of the coming prophet and where he would come and what he would look like and what he would say. He says, when the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, arrived in Medina, I was keen on going to look at what this man looked like and what he said, because I knew from the previous scriptures what to look out for. So he says, as he came into Medina, I tiptoed to get a glimpse of him. I tiptoed to get a glimpse of him because he was crowded by companions who were already Muslim. And what did he say? He says, I looked at this beautiful face, amazing face, and his words were calm and clear and correct and upright. And he was saying, أيها الناس أفشوا السلام وأطعموا الطعام وصلوا الأرحام وصلوا بالليل والناس نيام تدخلوا جنة ربكم بسلام. As soon as I heard this, I knew this is a messenger of Allah. Straight away. What's the meaning of it? He says, oh people. So this man is listening to the Prophet, peace be upon him, say, oh people, spread salam. The term salam means peace, but it has a much deeper meaning than just mere peace. It's the greeting as well. Assalamu alaikum. Greet everyone. Tusallim ala kulli man arafta wa man lam ta'rif. A teaching of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Greet those you know and those you don't know. Many of us, we only follow half of that. You know them, salam alaikum. You don't know them, they greet you. You look at them as though, what happened there? May Allah forgive us. Tusallim alayhim. What did you lose? Greet them. It's a prayer for them. May peace be upon you. The angels are saying, may peace be upon you too. Wow, wow. So he heard the first words, afshu salam, spread the salam. Wa at'imu ta'am, and feed people food. Be generous, be kind, don't be miserly, don't be stingy. Don't think of yourself, think of others. Reach out to them with food. Feed the people as much as you can. Wa at'imu ta'am, wasilul arham. Fulfill your family ties and relations. Learn to go out and mend that which is broken in terms of relations between you and your family members and the broader communities. Silul arham. وَصَلُّوا بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامٌ. And pray at night to the Lord while everyone is sleeping. Pray, pray often. Call out to your Maker. And what will happen as a result? You will enter the paradise of your Lord with ease, with peace, with goodness, with kindness. This man, Abdullah ibn Salam, says, when I saw this, it was a combination of everything put together. I immediately went up to him and I said, O messenger, I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship besides Allah. And I bear witness that you are indeed the messenger of Allah. If you know him, you will love him. Here we go, my brothers and sisters. Today is just the tip of the iceberg. By the will of Allah, we will be spending so many days, different activities, different means. And I'd like to call out to every single one of you to spend some time giving some form of a positive message about the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, to whomsoever is in your circle and beyond, be it on social media, be it interactions at your workplace, at home, with those who work for you, those whom you work for, whoever it may be, those whom you come across in your lives, in your day-to-day lives. Just say a good word, give a good message, or the minimum is, show them a good expression by the will of Allah. Be kind, and Allah Almighty will open our doors, and by His will and mercy, we will be resurrected with the one whom we love. Because the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, Al-mar'u ma'a man ahab. On the day of judgment and in the hereafter, a person will be with the one whom he or she loves. You love them the most? Here goes. And we love the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. May Allah bless you all. I thank you for this attentive ear. And I really would like to thank the government of Dubai for facilitating this, the Islamic Affairs, and all those brothers and sisters who made this happen, and all of you who made the effort to attend. May Allah reward all of us. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad.